Everyone, welcome to Magic TV. I am Tristan Shaun Gregson here one more time with U.S. Nationals champion Josh.
So feels good to hear.
I know. U.S. Nationals champion Josh Utter-Leyton. I finally found a way to get Josh to talk. We were brainstorming between segments and, you know, real simple question, but a real big question, which is, we love Magic. We play it. Some of us work with it. If you could change one thing about the game, Josh, what would it be?
I want combo to be a bigger part of Magic, or constructive Magic at any rate.
And then, you know, from there, what's combo? Is it lands plus Jace Mind Sculptor? fetch lands for Jace Mind Sculptor? I think that's a combo, right? What's combo for you?
Yeah, I mean, actually, I think that's, you know, a pretty good interaction. I don't want necessarily, you know, like, game-winning combos, something like Dark Depths. That's not exactly what I mean here. I just mean, you know, non-combat-oriented interactions. Something like Pyromancer's Ascension, I think, is very good for the game. It's, you know, this interactive combo. You can disrupt it pretty easily, and Pyromancer's Ascension can come back over the top with, you know, countermeasures to disruption. And, you know, it's interacting on, you know, just a different territory than just combat or just planeswalkers and things like that.
I mean, for someone who might have been playing the game on and off for a little while, you'll kind of see that combo decks in this classical sense have been kind of dwindling. Mind's Desire, Enduring Ideal, I mean, now current day with Pyromancer's Ascension, there are fewer and fewer. Mm-hmm. And again, you mentioned something that was really great to me, which is in the same deck you've got Dark Depths, which is a combo that you're not a fan of, and at the same time, a Thopter Foundry with the sword, which is a combo you are a fan of. What's the difference there? I mean, are they both like equal as far as combos? Like, what do you like? What do you not like? What do you want?
So, combo gets a pretty bad rap for being non-interactive, and that's because, you know, a lot of the time combo will be done poorly, and it will be dominant, and you'll have these actual non-interactive combo decks where, you know, the combo deck just does its thing and the opponent can't really interact with it at all, and that doesn't lead to fun Magic at all. What I like is interactive combo where, you know, there's actual decisions being made on both sides and the players are interacting with each other, and it's just, you know, different interactions than just creature combat and things like that. So, you know, Vampire Hexmage Dark Depths is a combo that I don't think is very interactive. Like, sure, Path to Exile can get it, but it's just too cheap and too good, and it's too easy to get around the disruption. Whereas something like Thopter Foundry, which is kind of the slower combo, and it doesn't just win the game immediately when it comes together, gives you more time to, you know, find answers and do something about it. I think that's very good. It leads to, you know, these interactive games where you can play Kasali Pride Mage, you can play Bant Charm, you can do all these other things to, you know, deal with it. While at the same time, the Thopter Foundry player isn't just, you know, colded by this disruption. They can also play countermeasures and, you know, beat those cards. And, you know, it just leads to these really good interactive games, whereas Hexmage Depths does not at all. It just, you know, ends games quickly.
A land and a two casting cost creature. That's all you need to get 20 points of damage that from an indestructible guy. I agree with you completely. I mean, I think that, again, we've seen the game shift so much where it's like who planeswalk firsts and whose creatures are better in the red zone. And that's so much of what Magic is now. You know, we used to talk about the rock, paper, scissors metagame where it was like combo, control, and aggro. Mm-hmm. And now it's kind of like aggro, control, mid-range.
Well, no, it's just all mid-range. There's no aggro and there's no control, you know.
We've talked about plenty of red decks. And you're not gonna try to sell me that that's a combo deck now. I mean, sure, maybe in this day and age where there isn't a combo deck in the classical sense, red is the combo deck, but we've moved so far away from it.
Okay, so there's still aggro.
Okay. In future sets, I mean, here we are. Mirrodin had some combo cards in the past. We're right before that set comes out. It'd be so nice if we could see something, even just like a glimmer of what old combo used to be. Proteus Staff allowed you to stack your deck back in the day. I remember doing that. It wasn't good, but you could still do it.
Yeah, I'm certainly hopeful. You know, I'm worried that R&D's stance against combo is not. It's not nice against combo, let's say. You know, Aaron Forsythe had an interview where he talked about combo, and he said that he liked having it in this place where you could, you know, come up with some creative new deck and beat somebody with it, and that's fine. But then, you know, he wants them to be able to, you know, just go and add four sideboard cards to his deck and then just never lose to that combo deck again. And I don't think that's a good place for combo to be.
I don't personally think any deck should be, you know, nullified by four sideboard cards. And yeah. I think that you and I kind of share the same thought process or school where it's like, combo can be interactive. Even a Mind's Desire deck can interact with your opponent. Like, it makes me, being the player, playing against the combo player, I am going to change the way I make plays, and I'm going to use my cards differently. If I know your deck is creatureless and you're a combo deck, I'm going to, you know, not only am I going to board cards out, but I am definitely going to play the game completely differently. And that's a skill set that's something to, that's great to learn in the game and is going to be interactive playing against that deck. Mm-hmm. And I think we both would like to see more of those cards. I mean, if you could bring
back... Yeah, I don't know that Mind's Desire is the best example since, you know, that's a pretty good poster child for non-interactive combo in that, you know, you just cast a bunch of spells and then they're dead on turn three, but...
Yeah, well... It extended, or even like, I remember bad standard decks where there would Mind's Desire with you would, you know, Wild Growth up a land like six times and twiddle it. You know. Not the worst, but I mean, what would you want to see combo wise then? More like not Mind's Desire. That's too over the top. But, mm-hmm. Like something like Enduring Ideal. You think that's kind of the right level? I mean,
yeah, Enduring Ideal is like perfect example of, you know, combo done right where. You go off and you still play Magic with your opponent. And you know, you're playing Magic with your opponent before you cast your Enduring Ideal too.
That's cool. I mean, I like it a lot. I think we both hope that Magic doesn't end up being like, well, who went first? Who got the Planeswalk first? All right, my creature has the advantage, we'll attack, that's game. And we both like the game enough that who knows, if it's done right, we'll still play it. But some kind of combo deck. I mean, Pyromancer's Ascension, thankfully, is out there. I mean, that is
yeah, I think that's a very good to have around in Standard.
I remember when you guys were testing for San Juan, and you and Matt Nass were sitting in the store, and you were desperately trying to write a Pyromancer's Ascension list. And you're like, just name all the blue or red instances of sorceries that do anything. I was like, well, there's that one where you like give a guy -1/-0, and then draw a card. You're like, that's great, we'll put that on a list. I'm like, you guys really want to make this work. Like, I guess that could be good. That could be drawing some cards, but that's a big devotion to it. And hopefully, when Wizards research and development, we'll see more Pyromancer Ascension-esque cards in the future and maybe move on from that and get something new and exciting for combo. So it's not Jace, and then, I guess Mythic Conscription is a combo. Sure. Would you say so?
No, it's just a creature. You know, you just cast your creature and then attack, and that's your combo.
Easy to say after you've won Nationals, but we'll see. Hopefully, so you've heard it here. U.S. National Champion would like to see more combo cards from Wizards of the Coast, and myself, the lowly Magic TV show host, would also like to see more of that in the future. Well, thanks for your input, Josh, and hopefully somebody out there is listening. Thanks for watching.